Over 70% of bladder cancers are urothelial carcinomas, which were previously termed transitional cell carcinoma. The most common primary symptom is hematuria or blood in the urine. The key to diagnosis is urinary cytology and then cystoscopy, which is a procedure where an endoscope or a thin tube with a light and a camera at the tip is inserted into the bladder via the urethra. They can be classified by histology. Urothelial carcinoma accounts for about 90% of bladder cancers, squamous cell carcinomas account for around 5% of cancers, and adenocarcinomas make up approximately 1%. Bladder cancers can also be classified based on their invasiveness. Non-muscle invasive bladder cancer is approximately 75% of all tumors, while muscle invasive bladder cancer is rarer and usually treated more aggressively with cystectomy, radical radiotherapy, or palliation. Key risk factors for bladder cancer include smoking, male sex, age over 55, exposure to chemical carcinogens, specifically aromatic amines used in rubber and dye industries, and systemic chemotherapy. As most of these carcinogens are concentrated and excreted in the urine, the bladder has a prolonged exposure. From what we describe as the field effect, urothelial tumors can be multifocal, and there may already be multiple tumors at presentation. Keep in mind that malignant transformation can occur anywhere in the urinary tract. The classic clinical feature is hematuria, which is characteristically painless and intermittent. If bleeding is gross, then clots may cause urethral obstruction, resulting in acute urinary retention. Moreover, tumors themselves can cause obstruction. Masses near the bladder neck may cause low urinary tract symptoms, while tumors arising near a ureteric orifice can obstruct urine coming from the kidneys, causing hydronephrosis. To investigate suspected urothelial carcinoma, consider urinary tests, cystoscopy, and further imaging. Urinalysis will detect hematuria, but urine can also be sent for cytology, and is most accurate for identifying high-grade cancer cells and carcinoma in situ. Cystoscopy is the key to making the diagnosis, though. Well-differentiated tumors form papillary frond-like lesions, whereas more aggressive tumors tend to form plaque-like lesions. Any tumor that are identified at rigid cystoscopy will require biopsy and further resection. Imaging can help stage cancer and characterize complications. Ultrasound examination may reveal hydronephrosis if there's ureteric involvement, and CT scanning may indicate local spread into the bladder wall and characterize metastatic disease. Now, management is really dependent on staging, and if the cancer is non-muscle invasive, locally invasive, or metastatic. In general, though, the initial management is usually surgical, and usually aimed at complete removal of the tumor by cystoscopic transurethral resection. Adjuvant therapy for high-risk patients might be given in the form of immediate postoperative intravesicular chemotherapy and delayed intravesicular BCG immunotherapy. Other more invasive treatments include radical cystectomy. If performed, some method of urinary diversion is required. One option is an ileal conduit formation with urine draining via a urostomy. For metastatic disease, chemotherapy agents like cisplatin are commonly used, as well as radiotherapy and immunotherapy with things like pembrolizumab. To remember the key risk factors, clinical features, and management of bladder cancer, I use the following simple mnemonic: AABBCCC for PP cancer. A key risk factor is exposure to aromatic amines from rubber factories. The key clinical features are either blood in the urine or blockage causing hydronephrosis or acute urinary retention. Bladder cancer can be managed with 4 C's: cystoscopic resection, cystectomy, and chemotherapy with cisplatin. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to check out my other videos and subscribe and turn on the notification buttons. It really helps me grow the channel. Thanks.